Hi everyone, in this video, we will show you how to create a better version of the whip effect in Vampire Survivors using Unity's Particle System component.
So for the whip, same thing as the lightning, the first thing we have to do is find a suitable effect for it. And I think I have just the effect in mind. Collection of sword. So this can be used as the whip, right? The whip effect. Okay, so we've got the sword slashers asset pack, and let's download that. Here is what I have. We have white slash thin, white group slashers, probably what we don't want. And this is actually the best for the whip. This isn't as good. So with sprites like that, what I like to do is I actually like to assemble them in a sprite sheet first. The idea behind sprite sheets is that if you need to load multiple images, you will need to access different areas of the hard drive, so this will make loading the assets slower. Whereas if you put everything into one file, then when you load the file, it's only one file. If you need to load multiple files from your hard drive, it's always going to take longer than if you only are loading one file. This is why having a sprite sheet is preferred. Then we do the same thing, we go to the sprite editor. We set this to multiple. Go to the sprite editor, we start slicing sprite. So, read by cell count, this will be 2 columns, 3 rows. Let's work a bit. So our whip is here. I'm gonna use a particle effect to animate this whip as opposed to using Animator, because I think that particle effects are a lot easier to get animations out of, actually. So let's do that. So, the particle system. I always set the rotation of the particle system to 0. It's just the thing I do. Because it's a lot easier to work with particle effect if the orientation of it and everything is set up properly. Sorting layer before ground. We will change, we will activate texture sheet animation. And there will be 6 sprites that we use, right? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we want this to be a burst with just one. And we don't want shape because we want the particle to always appear in one pixel. What if we have count of 2? Okay, let me randomize the lifetime to make the animation more dense. 1, 5. So there is some overlap in the... So what I'm making is I'm creating 2 particles instead of 1. So it makes the entire thing thicker. And for the start size, I'm actually gonna Let me just do... We just want to stretch the x-axis across, right? And it looks more like a whip now. So now we have the particle. And as usual, as with the lightning, we want to head over to the renderer, and we don't want to have any limits to the particle size, so we're going to set the max particle size to 100. Yeah, so that if we zoom in, the particle is allowed to get very big. The animation doesn't loop. And as usual, we also want the stop action to be destroyed. So what a stop action do is, after 1 second, then this destroys the entire object. Actually, it shouldn't last for that long, right? It should last for just 0.2 seconds, because that is how long the effect stays for. So I'm just gonna set it to 0.21. So it comes out and it very quickly is gonna destroy itself. Okay, again, notice that I'm using a particle effect to do the animation, because I think it's a lot easier to use particle effects with a sprite sheet, because then you don't have to create animator for your effects.
If you try to flip the effect by applying negative scale values, it wouldn't work. To fix that, you can use the default sprite material instead of the default particle system material.